Because water is capable of dissolving more substances than any other liquid, it is often referred to as the universal solvent. The key to this unique capability lies within its molecular structure. Because water is a polar molecule, it is capable of dissolving other polar molecules and ionic compounds. For example, when sodium chloride, which is commonly known as table salt, comes into contact with water, a process called dissociation occurs. The chemical elements in table salt are shaped together in a crystal lattice structure, held together by ionic bonds. These elements are sodium, which is positively charged, and chloride, which is negatively charged. Because these elements have a charge, they are referred to as ions instead of atoms. When introduced to water, the water molecules are attracted to these ions. The positive part of the water molecule, the hydrogen atoms, are attracted to the chloride ions, whereas the negatively charged oxygen atom is attracted to the sodium ions. This attraction generates a force that is stronger than the ionic bonds holding the sodium and chloride ions together, so the crystal structure starts to break. The water molecules surround and separate the ions from each other, keeping them apart. As a result, the solid salt crystal dissolves in water. If enough salt is added, the water molecules will reach a point where they cannot attract or dissolve any additional salt. This is known as the saturation point. An example of this saturation can be found in the Dead Sea, which is one of the most unique bodies of water on our planet. Salt in the Dead Sea comes from several sources. One of the main primary sources is from River Jordan, which carries salt and other minerals from surrounding land into the sea, as well as salt springs on the seafloor that further contribute to the salinity. Because the Dead Sea is located at the lowest land point on Earth, 430 meters below sea level, and experiences a very hot and dry climate, the water evaporation occurs faster than in any other seas. The high salt content also lowers the water's specific heat capacity, enabling it to heat and therefore evaporate quicker. There are also no outlets from the sea, so the water cannot flow towards other bodies of water, it can only evaporate. This means that the water evaporates but the salt doesn't. Instead, it accumulates, making the water in the Dead Sea extraordinarily salty. It is roughly 10 times saltier than regular seawater. This extreme saltiness has an interesting side effect. It increases the water's density. This is why floating is easier in the Dead Sea. Essentially, the increased density creates a buoyant force which pushes against the swimmer's body and keeps them afloat, making sinking virtually impossible. Despite being called the universal solvent, there are some substances that water cannot dissolve, such as oil. Water cannot dissolve oil due to their incompatible molecular structures. Oil is made up of non-polar molecules and therefore cannot be broken down by the polar water molecules. When mixed together, oil and water separate, with oil forming a layer on top of the water due to its lower density. This is what makes oil spills in water so catastrophic. The oil blocks the surface from sunlight, making it impossible for marine plants and phytoplankton to photosynthesize, which leads to a decrease in oxygen levels in the water. This disrupts the marine food chain, leading to mass deaths of various species and damaging biodiversity. Cleaning up an oil spill is an expensive and time-consuming process that doesn't always fully remediate the damage. The long-term consequences of an oil spill, such as destruction of habitats and the extinction of species, are irreversible. Around 60% of our bodies are made up of water, and its ability to dissolve substances is fundamental in human bodily functions, due to its role in nutrient transportation and temperature regulation. Nutrients in the body, such as vitamins, minerals, glucose, and amino acids, are primarily transported through water as it dissolves these substances, enabling them to be carried in the bloodstream to various organs and cells. This process ensures that the body's cells receive the necessary nutrients for energy production and healthy functioning. Water also dissolves waste products, enabling their elimination from the body, therefore purifying the system. When the temperature in our body rises, water distributes this heat evenly due to its high heat capacity, preventing our vital organs from getting too hot. This process is also known as thermoregulation, and it helps our bodies to maintain a steady internal environment, resisting sudden spikes in temperature. When the body overheats due to exercise or during a hot day, sensors in the brain detect this rise in our internal temperature. The body responds by activating the sweat glands to start releasing sweat onto the surface of our skin. Electrolytes such as sodium and chloride are dissolved in sweat, which creates an osmotic gradient. This osmotic gradient draws more water into the glands, ensuring that sweat flows steadily to the skin's surface. Once the sweat emerges, it performs its most critical task, evaporation. As each droplet clings to the skin, it absorbs heat from the body. As it begins to rise into the air, it carries away this heat, cooling the body in the process. And just as water evaporates from our skin, or from the surface of the Dead Sea, it transforms itself from a liquid to a gas as it evaporates into the atmosphere. This extraordinary transformation brings us to our next topic, where we will discover the three different phases of water.